doing the Deal or No Deal dance at 4 o'clock today. But now, step inside Rory's neon cage to play Face the Clock.
Hello and welcome to the show. We have six new contestants who know they not only have to beat each other, they must also defy the relentless march of time. Let's meet today's players.
Hi, I'm Gary. I'm from Clonoe in County Tyrone and I work night shift in a warehouse.
Hi, I'm Roz and I'm a retired administrator and I'm from Stockport.
Hi, I'm Joshua. I'm from Manchester and I'm a freelance filmmaker.
Hello, I'm David, I'm from Southampton, I'm a comedy entertainer.
Hello, I'm Erin, I'm from Camden, and I'm a secondary school teacher.
Hello, I'm Anthony, I'm from Newcastle, and I'm a writer of teaching resources.
Welcome, everyone. Now, you each drew lots before the show, and Joshua, you... OK, this is round three, where we have to lose yet another player. And let's look at the amounts we have here. Anthony and Gary, you were the two who battled it out with Roz in the previous round. You're on £300 each. Erin and David, you have yet to make any money at all. David, as you're the player on my left, you get to start the next round. Can I just first of all say how well you're playing? You've been absolutely
I'm
brilliant.
I'm actually flabbergasted. I've already reached my peak.
Yeah, you may have peaked too soon, actually. So what do you do for a living?
We're at the clubs. I'm a comedy vocal entertainer. I do gags, impressions, sing, compare, do everything, you name it.
OK, do you have a strategy here?
Not really. I'm just thinking of a classic Rolling Stones record. Hope the time is on my side.
Erin, can I say hello at this point?
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
You're under the radar at the moment.
I am.
Are you relieved about that?
A little, yeah. But I'm sure if I've just said that now, I've got a big target on my forehead.
So we know that 30 seconds and a minute have gone, so there's 45 seconds, quite a short time, but the rest are considerably longer. OK, the lights are flashing in front of me. If you'd like to hit the button and stop the light on one of the hidden times. Off you go. There you go. So the audience at home now know exactly how long that round will last. Sadly, none of us in the studio have any idea. But that's the game. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Start the clock. Which British coin, first minted in 1971, ceased to be legal tender in 1984?
Penny.
No, the halfpenny. The red kangaroo is native to which country?
Australia.
Correct.
Play.
Which animated TV show often featured the catchphrase, "Oh my God, they've killed Kenny"?
South Park.
Correct.
Play.
The Eighth Amendment of the US Constitution states that punishments should not be cruel and...
inhumane.
Unusual. According to legend, which mathematician formulated the law of gravity after witnessing an apple fall from a tree?
Isaac Newton. Play.
Correct. Play. In the children's stories by Michael Bond, which bear takes up residence with the
Paddington
brown...
Paddington Bear.
Correct.
Gary.
Gary. In the British military, the head of which of the three main armed services has the title First Sea Lord?
Nearby.
Correct.
Okay.
Anthony. The weight of diamonds and other precious stones is expressed in which unit of measurement?
Carats.
Correct.
Erin.
Erin, in New York City, the Great White Way is the nickname of the theatre district on which thoroughfare?
Broadway.
Correct.
Play.
What is the name of the fruit sometimes called Adam's fig, green banana or cooking banana that is widely used...
Don't know.
Plantain. In 1996, what was the title of the debut single by the Spice Girls?
All I Wanna. I don't know.
No, it was Wannabe, I'm afraid. According to the nursery rhyme, Wednesday's child is full
don't
of...
Don't know.
Woe. In clothing, which word meaning thing to wear is the name of a traditional full-length Japanese robe with...
Kimono. Pass. Gary.
Gary, what was the nickname of the jazz saxophonist Charlie Parker?
Don't know.
It was Bird. The imaginary lines that circle the Earth parallel to the equator are known as the lines of...
Pass.
Latitude. In 2003... Oh, dear. You knew that one, didn't you?
I did.
You just needed another 2 or 3 seconds to get it. That felt a little bit longer, that round.
A little bit, yeah.
Hello and welcome back to The Clock. David, Erin and Anthony have seen off three rivals and now one more must go before the final two square up in the face-off to decide today. It's now round four. And looking at the totals, Erin and David, you're on £500 each. Anthony, you have got the least money with £350, which means you will get to start. The next we in the studio have no idea. Anthony, are you ready? Good luck. Start the clock. Which is Australia's most populous city?
Sydney.
Correct.
Bay.
In aviation, the abbreviation LHR identifies which UK airport?
London Heathrow.
Correct.
David.
David, if an animal is described as nuciferous, it feeds mainly on what?
Leaves.
Nuts. The Pompidou Centre that houses the biggest display of modern art in Europe is in which capital city?
Paris.
Correct.
Play.
In the 1940 film Fantasia, which Disney character plays the Sorcerer's Apprentice?
Mickey Mouse. Play.
Correct. In the Arabian Nights tales, what is the name of the sailor who goes on seven voyages?
Sinbad.
Correct.
Erin.
Erin, the machine known as a gin was invented in 1793 by Eli Whitney to remove the seeds. Cotton. Which US state is nicknamed the Lone Star State?
Texas.
Oh, Erin, you were on the answer. I'm so sorry. As you said Texas, the buzzer went. It's another short round, I'm afraid. You knew the answer, but not time to get it out and pass to. Who do you pass to in any way?
I was going to pass to Anthony.
You were going to pass to Anthony. Anthony, you just dodged a bullet there. Why would you have done that?
Just because I hadn't passed to him yet.
Because it was your turn to be passed to.
I was spreading out the
line. We didn't get that far, Erin. That was the 45-second round, I'm afraid. Very, very quick. Erin, sadly, we have to lose you. The killer pass came from David. Why did you signal out, Erin?
No particular reason. Similar money, I just want to get on with it and just grab what I can.
Grab what
you can. No particular reason.
There you go. He's a man in a hurry, Erin. Don't stand in his way. I'm afraid your money, your £500, now goes to David, who goes flying up to £1,300. Erin, you are back to zero, and I'm afraid you have been defeated by the clock. Farewell, Erin. Thank you very much. So, whoever wins this round will automatically take the other person's money. Today's prize total is £1,800. David and Anthony, this is the face-off. Anthony, your strategy was survival. It's worked so far. You pleased with that?
Yes, I'm very happy to have got this far.
So now it's down to your general knowledge. How is your general knowledge?
Well, I write teaching resources. I help to write textbooks. So okay. I learn all kinds of weird and wonderful things in the course of my work. I don't really have any specialist knowledge about anything.
David?
Yeah.
You targeted Erin there. You took her out with the killer pass.
Yes, I think she's a smart cookie. And okay. Anthony's quite a smart cookie too, I think. So it could be interesting.
Well, you're up against Anthony in the face-off. You both ready, gentlemen?
Yep.
Now, in this round, you both have a clock with 1 minute on it, which, as usual, will count down out of sight. Anthony, you brought least money into the round, so you'll start. When I begin asking your questions, your clock will start ticking, and it'll keep ticking until you give me a right answer. Once you do, your clock will stop, and play will pass across to David, and his clock will begin to count down. We'll go back and forth between you after each correct answer until one of your clocks runs out, and that player is eliminated. Anthony, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Good luck. Start the clock. Anthony, according to the 1981 single by Kirsty MacColl, the guy who swears he's Elvis works where?
In the chip shop.
Correct. David, what W is the term used to describe the moon when it's progressing from full to new?
Wayne.
Correct. Anthony, in British politics, what's the full name of the man elected leader of the Labour Party in 2010?
Full name? Edward Miliband?
Correct. David, which pastry product often eaten for breakfast has a French name that means crescent?
Croissant.
Correct. Anthony, in traditional bingo calls, which number is prefixed with the word legs?
11.
Correct. David, who won the Best Actress Oscar in 2012 for her role as Margaret Thatcher in The Iron Lady?
Meryl Streep.
Correct. Anthony, which planet is named after the Roman god of the sea?
Neptune.
Correct. David, the murderesses Velma Kelly and Roxy Hart are the leading characters in which musical?
Chicago.
Correct. Anthony, which 1937 book by J.R.R. Tolkien has the alternative title There and Back Again?
Lord of the Rings?
No, it's The Hobbit. Still you, in TV soaps, which actress has played Sheila Grant in Brookside and Gloria Price in Coronation Street?
Don't know.
It's Sue Johnston. Which Swedish tennis player won the Wimbledon singles title every year from 1976 to 1980?
Bjorn Borg.
Correct. David, what is the penultimate letter of the modern English alphabet?
Y.
Correct. Anthony, of which country is Ottawa the capital?
Canada.
Correct. David, which biblical tower provided the title for the 2012 UK number one album by Mumford & Sons?
Sodom.
No, Babel. Although they're not closely related, which insects are sometimes known as white ants?
Don't know.
Termites. In the 50 Shades of Grey trilogy by E.L. James, what's the first name of the leading male character?
Anthony.
Christian. Which type of fruitcake that's decorated with almonds is known by the name of a Scottish city?
Dundee.
Correct. Anthony. In 1649, Oliver Cromwell was one of the 59 men who signed the death warrant of which king?
Charles the First.
Correct. David. Which Russian composer wrote the music for the ballets The Nutcracker and Swan Lake? Correct. Oh, just on the bell. I'm so sorry, I was still confirmed the answer, hadn't passed it across to Anthony. Oh, David.
Ooh, ouch.
Both of you had your moments there. So, talk me through what happened there.
A couple of stumbles there, I just didn't know them. So, it's the luck of the game. So.
It is. I mean, you can know 99 and it's the one that catches you out. Yeah.
Tchaikovsky nutcrackered me.
Anthony, you got stuck on Miliband.
Yeah, Edward was a guess.
Have you any idea, Anthony, how long you had left on the clock?
Very little time.
I can tell you now, there's 1 second between you.
Wow. Wow.
Heart of bear,
David. Very, very exciting. That was so close. David, you fought very well. You had the most money going into this. You've enjoyed it?
It's been good. It's good.
I'm afraid we have to lose you. Thank you so much. The clock has beaten you. Goodbye. Congratulations. We needed 5. I'm so sorry.